So there's the camera, and that would give you a view. That's the lens right there, that little tiny hole. Shot this way, you guys have hopefully seen the videos where I sometimes point it backwards like that. I call it reverse cowboy. What I thought I'd do is kind of arm this jet so you can kind of see what she's made of. So that's where your battery sits. That's the receiver with the little antennas off of it. This is your mains. And I'm going to plug it in here to the battery. Okay. Let's hang on one sec. Let me get a way to hold this camera. All right. Tripods. What an invention. All right. So first thing you want to make sure you do before you plug in your battery is you turn the radio on first. Put your throttle down. This is throttle. So you want this down. This fan in this plane, that little turbo fan, it would shoot it across this room and do exponential damage potentially. So yeah, make sure your radio is throttled down and everything else is not in some wacky positioning. So I've got my like servo reversing and whatnot. That's what this is down here all set, right? So now we'll plug it in and you'll hear it arm when I do it. It'll give a series of beeps. And that's the servos. Okay, so that sound is the international symbol for your plane is armed and ready. So over here we control our flaps. If you look to the back here, let me make sure that's in frame. You see that back flap there? That's the elevator. So that's this here. We go down, elevator down, up. That elevator flap, I can show you something interesting here. Alas, this thing has been flying really nice. I just had it out recently. It's screaming along. I'm going to carefully kind of try and, I don't know if I can show you here, but the linkage right here on the rear. See on this one, it's got that little linkage rod, and this side doesn't. It ripped clean off when I landed, and I left the field without knowing. So I ordered a new linkage rod. It's like a couple bucks. I have a few extras, but of course I didn't have the right size. They look like this. Here's linkage rods. So those basically control the, they hook onto a little doohickey like this. It goes on the bottom of the wing, on the flap. You can set the throw with those three holes. Depending on which hole you use is how fast or slow the flap will, and how much actually the flap will move. They call it a throw, so you can put it like at a high throw setting or a lower throw. I usually go with a medium. So anyway, now we can do ailerons. That's our wing flaps. So that's left and right. And so you can do a mix when you go like a diagonal move. You're going to get a mixture of aileron and elevator. See that? And that's how you make a plane do all this. Okay. And then the other thing is on the throttle here, that controls the rudder. But the rudder is set up on this plane to work the front nose gear. See that? That's my rudder channel, which is this, the front wheel. So the rudders would normally be and are on an F-15, where rudders always are, and that's on these, the tail wings. This has a set of twin. You can see the cutout where you could conceivably put a rudder, but you really don't need it. They call these just bank and yanks. So let's do some throttle. You can hear this thing throttling up a little bit. It's going to be a little loud. So that's at the lower setting. The throttle, have to make sure it doesn't fly, is this one here. So if you like. So as I throttle up, I've got to hold the plane or it's actually going to try and fly. It's going to be like this. It was blowing my comic books around back there. So, yeah. That's what this bad boy does. And Dom is always very curious when I do that. He's like, what in the hell are you doing in here? What is that, Dom? That's my best friend right there. Yeah, that's the plane. Remember, buddy? Wow. So thanks for checking it out, guys.